discuss how to measure the volume of solids, whether it was a regular shape solid or whether it was irregular shape solids. Certain formulas were there. Why? Because the dimensions were fixed. Now let us talk about how to measure the volume of liquids. Now in terms of liquid, in case of liquid, liquid generally does not have fixed shape. So since liquid does not have a fixed shape, it is very difficult to measure the volume by using any formula. So how we can measure the volume of liquids? So we can measure the volume of liquids. The volume of liquids can be measured by using a container. By using a container, that is measuring cylinders. It can be measuring cylinders. It can be conical cans. What kind of cans? Conical cans, and it can be Eureka cans. So we can use these kind of containers or devices with the help of which you can measure the volume of liquid. Over here we will first take the capacity of that liquid. So what is the capacity? It is, you can say, the maximum quantity of liquid that a container can hold. The maximum quantity of liquid. The maximum quantity of liquid. The maximum quantity of liquid a container can hold is its capacity. So first term you have to learn is what is capacity. The maximum quantity of liquid a container can hold is known as its capacity. So we are having different types of devices. You can say measuring cylinders are there, conical cans are there, and Eureka cans of different capacity, using which you can measure the volume of liquid. First we talk about measuring cylinder. Now, you must have seen in dairies, or you must have seen a milk man comes to your house and when he wants to deliver milk to you, in that condition, how he will measure the milk? He will use this kind of container, which is known as a measuring cylinder. It is of different capacities. A smaller one is there, which must be of 500 milliliter. A bigger one will be there, which can be of 5 liters also, and a medium size can be there of 1 liter, and different containers can be there. So the size of the container is actually its capacity. How much amount of liquid it can hold. So first type of cylinder is there, a measuring cylinder, which is this kind of a shape is given, in which you have to pour the liquid. A marking will be there. With that marking you have to fill it. How much amount of liquid it is holding, that will give you the accurate volume of that particular liquid. Now when you go to market to buy oil, like suppose mustard oil, in that condition you must have seen a different kind of container is there, which is known as this conical can. What kind of can? Conical can. In this can, it is also different sizes, 0.5 liter, 100 ml, 200 ml, 500 ml, 1 liter, 2 liters. So different capacities are there with the help of which you can measure the liquid, that is oil, and we will going to sell you. So over here, remember one thing. In solids, we were talking about the volume in centimeter cube, meter cube. Over here, we talk about in liters, milliliters. So liters. First, the standard unit for calculating the volume of liquid is in liters. The standard unit for calculating the volume of liquid is liter. So what is 1 liter? 1 liter will be equal to 1000 milliliters. When we say 1 liter, it means how many milliliters are there? 1000 milliliter. And what is 1 milliliter? 1 milliliter is equal to 1 centimeter cube. So whenever we take a volume of 1 centimeter cube, that will be equal to 1 milliliter. So when you add a 1000 centimeter cube, it will become 1000 milliliter, that is equal to 1 liter. So 1 liter can be equal to 1000 centimeter cube. And 1 milliliter will be equal to 1 centimeter cube, which you have to remember. So SI unit for measuring the volume of liquid is liters, smaller unit is milliliters. So these were the things which you have to remember, and we will learn how to measure accurately the volume of any liquid. Okay, now we will learn how to measure the volume of liquid very accurately. Accurate measurement of liquid. So for that we will require a measuring cylinder in which the markings will be given 0 ml, 10 ml, 20 ml, 30 ml and so on. So whatever kind of capacity you are taking or choosing. You may be taking a bigger one, you may be taking a smaller one. So over here we are taking a smaller one. So how to measure the volume of liquid very accurately? For that, very first thing, the measuring cylinder should be kept on horizontal surface. So the surface on which you have kept the container, it should be very much horizontal. It should be proper smooth. So that whatever the liquid you are pouring, it should measure the accurate reading. Secondly, your eyes should be in front of the maximum level of the liquid. Wherever you can see that the liquid end is there or the upper part of the liquid is there, your eyes should be in front of that. You are not supposed to look from the top or you are not supposed to look from the bottom. If you are looking from the bottom or you are looking from the top like this, in that condition the measurement will not be so accurate. So your eyes should be very much in front of the level of the liquid. So the eye should be in front of surface of liquid. Third thing, before pouring the liquid, you should check that the cylinder must be clean and dry. So before pouring the liquid, check the cylinder should be clean and dry. So these things you have to keep in mind for accurate measurement of the liquids using a measuring cylinder. Now, after learning the measurement of volume of solids and liquid, now let us talk about how to measure the mass and weight of an object. So let us begin with mass. So what is mass? It is the amount of matter present in an object. So any object is there, it is made up of matter, made up of atoms, molecules, ions, etc. So how much amount of matter, how much amount of molecules, how much amount of atoms are present in that object, that total quantity is known as its mass. So more amount of matter or more amount of atoms are present, you can say that the mass is more. Less amount of matter or less amount of atoms or molecules are present, you can say that the mass is less. So the first thing you have to remember, that what is mass? It is the amount of matter. It is the amount of matter present in an object. So amount of matter present in an object is known as its mass. Now we have learned what is mass. So how to measure mass? So we can measure mass in kilograms. That is the standard unit. The SI unit of mass is kg. That is kilogram. As everybody is aware about kilogram, basically we measure the mass of an object in kilogram. But the smaller unit, the CGS unit, that is the smaller unit of mass, is grams and milligrams. So basically the smaller units of mass is milligrams and grams. What about the bigger units? That is the multiple units. For the bigger units, there is quintal and tons. So these are the units of mass. The SI unit of mass is kg, that is kilogram. The smaller unit, that is the CGS unit of mass, is grams and milligrams, whereas the bigger units of mass is quintals and tons. How we can measure the mass? Now we know the units, we know the definition. We can use a beam balance, the device which is used to measure the mass of object. Remember in the first lecture we have talked about, by using a beam balance we have measured the mass of rice. So that is actually the mass we are measuring. So how we can measure the mass of any object? By using a beam balance. So beam balance is a device which is used to measure the mass of an object. Then what is weight? Weight, it is the force, weight towards its center. So if an object is kept on the surface of the earth, like I am standing on the surface of the earth, the tables are kept, your pencil box is kept, your school bag is kept, so they all are being attracted by the earth. That is the gravity of the earth is attracting. So when this gravity of the earth is multiplying with the mass of the object, the product is known as weight. So what is weight? It is a product of mass and gravity. So it is a force with which the earth pulls a body towards its center. So the formula for calculating the weight of the object becomes mass into gravity, M into G. So weight of the object depends upon mass also, and it depends upon gravity. But mass, it does not depend upon gravity. The weight, the mass of the object depends only upon amount of matter. So you can say that mass of an object is constant. It is a constant value. Constant means whatever is the mass of the object in one place, the mass of the object, of that particular object, will remain same throughout everywhere, whether the gravity is changing or not changing. But since the weight of the object depends upon mass and gravity, so mass will be same, but gravity can change from one place to another place. Like suppose if you are moving from earth to moon, in moon the gravity is very less. In Jupiter the gravity is different. In different planets, in different parts of the space, the gravity will be different. So where the gravity will become zero, there the weight will also become zero. So the weight of the object can be zero also. But will the mass of the object be zero? No. The mass of the object cannot be zero because it consists of some amount of matter. So the mass of the object cannot be zero. The weight of the object can be zero. What is mass? It is the amount of matter present in the object. What is weight? It is the force with which the earth is pulling that object towards its center. So formula for calculating the weight is mass into gravity. What remains constant? The mass remains constant. What may vary? Weight may vary from place to place. Now its unit. Since it is a force, the SI unit for mass is Newton. The SI unit for weight is Newton. So weight is basically measured in Newton. In CGS unit, smaller units, the weight is measured in dyne. D-Y-N-E, dyne. And 1 Newton is equal to 10 raised to power 5 dynes. So this you have to remember. Now how we can measure the weight of an object? You can measure the weight of an object by a simple device which is known as spring balance. So which device is used to measure the weight of an object? Spring balance is a device which is used to measure the weight of an object. Which device is used to measure the mass of an object? Beam balance is used to measure the mass of an object. So these were the things, the measurement of mass and weight.